welcome back to Palm Breeze Cafe. And Kim, we're going to talk about something we never dreamed we would be talking about.
Really? You're right. I never would have thought about this. But Lee Kolbert never fails to amaze us with the things that she can find out. She ferrets them out. She's like a bloodhound.
You're worse than me.
She's like something canine related.
Lee, tell us about this fascinating thing that you found.
Well, before I do, I'm willing to give up some of my time for Kim to show us his impression of his dog.
Okay, I'm a dog lover. We have a dog who gets very excited at home whenever it's time to go out for a walk, and it looks something like this. So, there you go.
I think they all do, don't they?
Yeah, they
do. Thank you, Kim.
That was for you, Tasha, out there, wherever you are.
Had to do it. Yes, believe it or not, there is a social network for dogs and cats, actually, but I'm going to show you the one for dogs because I'm a dog person. Why should we have all the fun? I mean, after all, dogs want to be social, too. I mean, dogs are social animals, right?
But not usually online. That's the part I'm missing here.
Well, you never know. When we're not home, who knows what they're doing?
Good point.
If you go to UnitedDogs.com, you can sign up for an account just with your email address and a password, and United Dogs allows you to create your own profile. And here you can see I've got my own profile here. What you do is you register where you live and a little bit about yourself, and you're automatically given some bonus points, and you have an opportunity to earn more bonus points. And what you can do with that is you can pat other dogs and you can give them gifts, and just like on MySpace and Facebook, you can deliver little gifts for birthdays and, you know, for, you know, if you like the dogs and if you want to be their buddies and all that. You can see over here, you can register your dogs, and I've got Kobe here. We call him Kobe Doodles. Hey, Kobe Doodles. And his breed and where he's living and all that. And he even has an update, okay? And right now, Kobe is snoozing, and I don't change that very often because Kobe is frequently snoozing, okay? And this is also what he's doing, and he's causing trouble while mom and dad are out. Well, I can also add comments to my profile page, and these are all the things that I can see from my page as well. But I'm going to go ahead and go to my dog's page, and here's a listing of my dogs. Oops, sorry. Let me go ahead and click on Kobe's page, and Kobe gets his own dog page. He gets his own URL. It's at uniteddogs.com/dog/Kobe Doodles. So you can visit. Stop laughing over there, Lee and Kim, okay? Using up my time here.
I'm just picturing a dog blogging all this stuff on you.
He is. He's a blogger, okay? So we've got his breed and his nicknames, color, and this is all important information because other dogs want to find him. And so when they want to find him, of course, they want to find buddies that are just like them. So here's his home page, here's his favorite toy, and he's even here on a map. And you can find other dogs based on their location by clicking on the map. And I also was able to rate him based on his personality, based on his energy level and intelligence and friendliness and so on. Kobe even has buddies. So I can click around here, and here are some of his buddies. And here's Amiga Savannah. And I happen to know from my social networking, this particular person has joined United Dogs and given Kobe a buddy, his dog. And so here is Amiga Savannah, and this is this dog is living in Mexico. So these dogs have become buddies, and they're just loving it.
Chihuahua? Okay?
So what's that?
Is that a Chihuahua in Mexico, or? Water
you know what? I didn't catch the breed. But I also have here's my buddy section, and I can see that I've got some dogs waiting to be buddies that I can accept or not accept. And you even have the opportunity of keeping your dog's profile private and only available to dogs that you accept as friends, because you know you never know if your dog needs to be protected from pedophiles, right? So it's a great little site if you're a dog lover and you want to get your dogs together with other dogs and just have some fun.
Do you feel like this is a straight line for an entire segment?
God knows dogs are concerned about privacy. I mean, yes. you know, that's...
Don't go there, Ken.
Yeah.
Just stop.
Okay. I did create an account for my dog, Tasha Lee, so maybe we'll be able to, our dogs can friend each other
whatever,
and they can exchange something.
On the serious side.
No, you know, that's very...
That was serious. That was serious.
Dog is... Yes. Well, let's go back maybe to...
You know what? A lot of kids have dogs.
Kids have dogs.
Kids have dogs. Maybe...
Maybe we should talk about kids.
Maybe we should talk about kids.
Hey, Jamey.
Oh, my God.
We're trying to think of all the ways that we could be silly about this dog
goodness.
Website.
Lee
but
Kolbert is all the ways? Woman. I'm through. I mean, we don't even need to do the rest of the show.
No, come on. You can.
That was awesome.
Bring us on down.
Let me relax, relate, and release. Okay, so we're going to do kidsspace.org, and it is international.
Okay.
And it's good, you know, because animals are like in Mexico, so
right.
This could be in Mexico as well. So kidsspace.org is a really cool website. It's designed for kids, especially under the age of 13. So you're not going to get much work from any child around the country that is not that is older than that. So it's really cool. It's very authentic kids work. So let's take it out. Let's check it out at kids-space.org. So when you come up here, they have several different options that you can go to. The first thing I'm going to go to is the Kids Gallery. Now, the Kids Gallery is very cool because it allows students to be able to create original pieces of artwork and by topics. Let's say, for example, we want to make animals. All of these are pictures that were created by students that were posted on the web. This is a piece of artwork that was created by a student. Let's say, who created this? Let me back up. By Ivy, who's age 10. The name of it is Night Owl, and she's from the United States. It's a very interesting piece of work. And as a kid, you can log on. You can actually type your story if you want to come up with a story for this. You just tell where you're from, and you can comment on this story. The interesting piece about this is it's so interactive that these little blue beans down here, these are all stories that were commented or created for this picture. So for example, this story by Jennifer from the United States for Ivy, who's also from the United States, this story was created by Jennifer for Ivy's picture. Now, this seems very, very, you know, nice and cute, but what happens is the educational implications of this is very powerful, because what you can do is you can actually create stories. Let's go down to the storybook page here. Stories based on a monthly stories. Let's go to September 8th. And let's go to The Chocolate Frog by Maggie and Olivia, who are age 7. The website will give you icons of the month, and you will create a story based on these icons. So you can see as a classroom teacher, even down here where you have the school pot, we don't have a lot of time, but a teacher can actually create a website for their classroom. They can actually post original pieces of artwork as inspiration for writing prompts, or you can create writing prompts as inspiration for artwork. So this is a very, very powerful tool as far as getting students to be able to interact with one another across the world. I have one more thing I want to show you that's super neat. This children's traditional costumes. You can create a costume, take a picture of yourself as a child. They will scan it in for you. They will create a file that shows your traditional costumes of your country. They even have games where you can test and see if you know which costume comes from which country. Just a wonderful site for interaction and getting students to be interested in cultures that are beyond their world and writing and artwork. So I think it's an awesome.
What's the address again one more time?
This is www.kids-space.org.
Great. That sounds great. So we got kids, we got dogs, we got all the bases covered.
We're going to come back and we're going to talk more about some real cool things with technology. Maybe not quite as entertaining, but definitely learning.